What's up, YouTube? ODST General back again with some Operation Trebuchet news this week. So this is one of those cases where patience pays off a little bit. I have a lot to show you guys visually this week, as opposed to, say, last week where there was nothing. So let's go ahead and start with official stuff and then get into the non-official stuff. So officially, there's only a couple things being done, but that is the Spartan helmets that I mentioned last week. Immortal Phoenix had messaged me after the last video, and he had shared some helmets that he's working on, shared the images of them. So on screen, you guys are going to be seeing the Grenadier helmet, the Gungeneer helmet, and the one that I don't believe was mentioned at all last week was the Rogue helmet that he's actually apparently working on too. So that's pretty awesome. So that's a new reveal. Obviously, we already knew about the other ones, but just seeing the work in progress form is really cool to see that they are there, they're modeled out and being worked on. The other thing that Immortal Phoenix shared with the community as a whole is his work in progress Spartan airborne rendering, basically. So this is going to be a Spartan army airborne Milaner permutation that you can get once it's completed. So he's currently working on this, and then once this is completed, from the way I understand it, is he will be working on the standard army airborne armor for just like regular Marines or UNSC Army, I guess would make more sense. At any rate, though, you can see that this one is a little bit different from current armors in the mod. It does have the one shoulder pauldron, the large one that's already existing, the Marine shoulder pauldron on the other side. But he's got it shown off with his work in progress airborne helmet that he's doing again. And this one seems to also come with a backpack too, so that's pretty neat. So looking forward to seeing that actually completed and modeled out. I'm actually wondering here if one of these might even be the standard Marine kit for it. So I'm looking at the models here, and as it switches around, they just start to look a little bit different. No. I think it's just some changes he made in the model to add extra detail. I'm pretty sure those are actually both Spartan now that I look at them again. But yeah, other than that, let's go ahead and get into the non-official news. So non-officially, I don't have much to actually show you guys. Burgess did talk a little bit about OpCan, very little bit, but basically he has said he's handing off his map to somebody else. The other person did gladly accept the map from him. Unfortunately, I don't know who that would be for sure. My first guess would be Nido Vizard, but no one was actually said. It could be Lumnuan too. I know it wasn't me, so because I can't even get my own map done. So I'm not sure who's taking that over. If it was Nido Vizard, I know he's currently working on another map at this moment for Warhammer. Lumnuan, I'm not sure what he's got going on for mapping wise right now for the mod. So I'm not sure where Burgess's map's going to be kicked around to, or how long until we hear something on that or see an update for that. But with that being said, at least it is still being worked on. It was handed off, so that's a little bit of something for us. Other than that, guys, you know, that's really all I have to talk about this week. I know I said I had a whole bunch of stuff, and visually speaking, I feel like that's true, but not a huge amount to talk about still, but there was still some really awesome stuff that I'm very excited about. Other than that, guys, take it easy. Make sure to like, subscribe, and share the video. As always, I want to hear what your favorite thing from today's video was and what you're looking forward to the most. Meme says Covenant, but we'll see what you guys say. Take it easy.